I'm here with Chance Sanders from Mission Knives.
What's going on, man?
To see you.
Yes, sir.
And he's going to tell us a little bit about the new stuff for Mission Knives right now.
All right. Well, as you guys know, we've got our titanium models that have been really popular. We've got some of the smaller knives that I'm liking. And these, a lot of these things are not necessarily new for this year, but it's just a lot of these designs are tried and true. If you're a kayaker or anything like that, this thing doesn't rust. Holds in edge for a long time. I have one of the other models here. I took this thing and drove it to a 55-gallon drum. We were out camping and we had a barrel, really, a burn barrel. And I just took a hammer and drove it through there. And it holds up. So a lot of companies try to put new stuff out every single year. This knife's been in production for 20 years now. They have NSN numbers on there. The first time I saw this was the ring. One of our guys had it. So we've done trying to move from just strictly military into civilian side of the house, more outdoor stuff. But
And like something like this is whether people realize it or not, you know, a lot of people walking around, like if you're living in the city, you don't walk around with a knife on. I tell you what, me personally, I can't stand not. I usually carry a multi-tool. I can't stand not having it, because just having a small little knife on you all the time is so handy. It's got so many uses. You know,
feel the weight. I'll show you. And this is how I wear mine. Just a neck knife.
And yeah, it weighs nothing. I mean, it's there's nothing to it.
No weight. So, but it's something like that. Having a fixed blade knife on you all the time is great. It's like we're talking about any kind of a urban disaster scenario where you're trying to get home or bug out. And I hate to use the term bug out because attached so many different scenarios to it, you know, and me bugging out is, it's a bad here, I'm going to move over here where it's not bad anymore, whatever that entails for you.
So, and you also do, you know, urban survival videos and stuff like that, and can you talk a little bit about it, and you got your bag here, can you talk a little bit about it, and a little bit about the mindset, you know, because a lot of people, like, you know, when there was the disaster, when Hurricane Sandy just happened, there were so many people that had no preparation, you know what I mean? And preparation just is, you know, I mean, personally at my house, I try to keep at least 6 cases of water, and I've got some food, you know, in cans. I'd make sure that I've got some canned food, so that way, if I had to, you know, if I couldn't get out of the house for a week or whatever, I'd be okay, you know, so.
My thing came from growing up, I grew up in the South, out in the woods, and we had a big garden every year, we raised animals, and we canned our food, and it was just a way of life.
Sure.
My dad picked cotton as a kid. That's how close you are to, you know, old school living. And after seeing that kind of lifestyle, once I got out, and like, you guys go to the grocery store every week. You know, it just really didn't make sense to me. And there was a point in my life before I went to Marine Corps that I got dropped off in the city. I'd never been out there. So some guys, and they left me there. And I had no idea, no money, no way of getting anywhere. So I was homeless for about 3 months. At the end of that 3 months, I had a car to drive, had a new ID, and a place to live. So knowing what it's like to be on the streets and how to bring yourself out of that gave me some real insight. You know what it's like to be hungry, know what it's like for people to cross the street when you're walking by because they want to avoid you, you know, that kind of stuff. So after the military and everything, and the wilderness side of the house, a lot of people were asking me, why live in the city? What do I do? And everybody else is telling me we just need to move to the States. And I'm like, it's not, everybody can't do that. You know, we live in urban environments, we come to urban environments. And what do we do if something happens? So I started getting some more training. I went through Kevin Reeves' class on tactical escape evasion class. And, you know, just started kind of building on that. And, you know, I carry different layers of gear, what's in my pockets, and then what's in the bag, and then step it up. Like you said, if you're either at home, you're going to stay. If you're away from home, you need to get home. If you're at home, you're going to leave. Everything falls in those 3 categories. And once you start looking at that, it's pretty simple. You know, just simple planning and having something to plan. That's the biggest thing I think people lack. You know, they have a lot of gear, but they don't know how to use it. It's like, you got all this stuff, now go. Where do I go?
Having stuff doesn't equal being ready for an emergency.
No, it's mindset, skills, training, thank you.
Wise words, very wise words. Thank you very much.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much.